Hello everyone, this is no one in particular, talking about nothing in particular. And before we get started with today's video, I just want to say, before we go into the Patreon shoutouts, I've had some trouble with YouTube community posts, so I haven't been able to update you guys on anything recently. I've just been having some technical errors, so if you do want to keep up to date with what I'm talking about and what I'm doing, then you can try joining the community Discord or following me on Twitter. But as of right now, YouTube community posts aren't working, so I'll be sure to get back to those when they do work, but yeah, links to those will be down in my link tree in the description and the pinned comment. But back to the Patreons, I want to give a very big shout out to Hillary Clinton Fangirl, Joey, Just Kai Things, 3D, Boyd Vanier, Murray, Priscilla, Foop Hoof, and Noea. Thank you very much, all of you, for all of your support. I really, really appreciate it. But with that out of the way, I hope you take care of yourselves, I hope you take care of others, and I hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you. Okay, so here we are down at the sleep lab. If you'd just like to get one of the beds here, make yourself comfortable, and let's try and get you some sleep, eh? Okay, so since I'm your doctor, I'm going to have to try and keep this as professional as possible, but I would just like to inform you that I'm going to try some methods that may help you sleep that will require some light bodily contact, mostly around the ears and the head area. So as long as you're comfortable with that, then I'll be more than happy to proceed, but if at any point I do something that makes you feel uncomfortable, then please don't hesitate to tell me, and I'll stop doing what I'm doing, and we can talk about it, okay? Okay, good. See, the goal here is to try and make you relaxed and fall asleep, so if there's anything that's making you uncomfortable, that's just going to cause stress, and yeah, you're not going to be able to sleep in those conditions. So, please, if any of this is too much, just let me know, okay? Great. So, just to go into a bit more detail about what we're going to do. There's this term that's been used, sort of, a bit unscientifically, but there's been a few reports on it, and it's called ASMR. Or autonomous sensory meridian response. And what it basically is your body having a automatic sensory reaction to particular auditory stimuli. And whatever stimuli triggers it is subjective from person to person. So just to clarify, not everything that I'm going to do to you is necessarily going to trigger the ASMR, but even if it doesn't, it will hopefully still be relaxing for you. The response in particular is basically like a tingly sensation that's a bit similar to paresthesia or frisson, or auditory tactile synesthesia. And the response itself is supposed to be a pleasant one. So if it's not pleasant, then tell me, I'll stop. But you should feel a tingling sensation somewhere around the scalp that quickly spreads down your neck, through the spine, and maybe across the shoulders and arms. It might also give you like goosebumps or, you know, just a general pleasant sensation across the skin, hopefully. So does that sound like something you'd want to try? Very good. Okay, well, just close your eyes and I'll get started, okay? Okay, so this is going to require me to get fairly close to you, but I'll try and keep my voice down. So if you do start to fall asleep, I don't accidentally wake you. So first I'm going to try some scratches of the hair. It should be both a pleasant sensation and a triggering noise, and a noise that should trigger ASMR. So just to begin with, I'm going to start at the front, scratch your head like this, and then I'll slowly work around over to your left side, then to your back, and then to your right side. Some people prefer the noises to one side, as opposed to the other, as it helps trigger the ASMR more strongly on that side. But since we're not sure yet, I'll make sure to go all around. I think that's enough for the front for now. So now I'm just going to come over to this side. Hair, by the way.
It's definitely one of my favorite triggers when it comes to So that might be why I decided to do it fast. Okay, I think that's enough for the head scratches. How did that feel? Whispering itself can be a very strong trigger for some people, and I'll make sure to go all the way around. From one side to the other. Okay, so see, now that I've told you how the anticipatory tingles work, you might start expecting them. Even when there isn't one. I suppose the last trick.